who gives this woman to this man? Thank you. If you were to look at your programs, you would notice that at the end, we present the couple, and that is when Preston kisses Sharifa. So we're going to ask him to control himself until we get to the end of this ceremony. Want to welcome you to this wonderful occasion. We appreciate your attendance and your support for the wedding of Preston and Sharifa. I'm reading from John chapter 2, story that is quite similar to this one. It begins by saying, on the third day there was a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Now both Jesus and his disciples were invited to the wedding, and when they ran out of wine, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." Jesus said to her, "Woman, what does your concern have to do with me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Whatever he says to you, just do it." Now there were set there 6 water pots of stone according to the manner of purification of the Jews, containing 20 or 30 gallons apiece. Jesus said to them, "Fill the water pots with water." And they filled them up to the brim. And he said to them, "Draw some out now and take it to the master of the feast." And they took it. When the master of the feast had tasted the water that was made wine and did not know where it came from, but the servants who had drawn the water knew, the master of the feast called the bridegroom. And he said to them, and this is where I want us to focus, "Every man at the beginning sets out the good wine. And when the guests have well drunk, then the inferior. But you have kept the best wine until now." Seems like that should be read again, doesn't it? Let's read that again. And he said to him, "Every man at the beginning sets out the good wine. And when the guests have well drunk, then the inferior. But you have kept the best wine until now." Isn't that kind of what we do? We start off in our relationships by setting out the good wine. You know, you opening the doors for folk and you politely saying good morning and good evening, and you taking people out to eat and giving little cards and whatnot, you know. Got your hair all done and everything, just smiling and giving words of affirmation, and, "Oh, you just look so handsome and so sweet." We're putting out the good wine, you know, and once the good wine does its thing, people get inebriated and intoxicated, and we find ourselves head over heels in love, and all of a sudden we standing in front of a community of onlookers, and we about to pledge our everlasting life because we've drunk the good wine. But then what happens is, after the wedding, once we go on back and time starts to settle in and we get a little comfortable and we get content, you know, and we start expanding around the waist and we start adjusting different things. When we decide, it ain't that deep that I really get my hair done every week, and I don't really need to work out, you know. You can get your own door. We actually got the remote thing, and I don't feel like going out to dinner tonight, and you want me to affirm you? When's the last time you affirmed me? We start giving out the inferior wine. We figure, I got it now. I mean, what's the big deal? I mean, you mine and I'm yours. There's no need for me to spend all of my energy and all of my hard-earned resources trying to wine and dine you. I did that already. And Preston and Sharifa, that is why our marriages fail. we start off with the good wine, and then we start serving the inferior wine. We start serving stuff that's not foolproof, you know, watered down variations of a bunch of concoctions that have no place in our marriage. Inferior wine, shabby wine, half-baked wine. Brother over here said gas station wine. But notice what happened when Jesus got in the wedding. When Jesus gets in the wedding, something strange happens. You no longer give the good wine and then start serving inferior wine. No, 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 no. When Jesus gets in the place, there's a transformation in the relationship. When the guests have well drunk, you no longer give inferior wine, but you start giving the best wine. What I want us to understand is that everything in human relationships, everything in planet Earth tends toward decline. Everything tends toward atrophy. If you don't cut your grass, you get weeds. If you don't work out, you gain weight. Everything in this world goes downhill. But when you got Jesus in your life, when you got Jesus in your heart, when Jesus is in the relationship, things don't go down, they start spiraling up. Jesus enables you to start pulling out better wine and greater wine and creative wine and blessed wine. We want to make sure that Preston and Sharifa keep giving better and better wine. And the only way you can do that is when you take your little weak water each day to Jesus. Ask him to transform your water into wine. Ask him to take your watered down attitude and transform it into wine. Ask him to take your watered down unforgiving heart and transform it into wine. Ask him to take your watered down preferences and preconceived ideas and ask him to give you nothing but God created wine. And tell me you won't drink. Oh, you all will enjoy the love that God ordained and imagined when he created the two of you. All we must do each day is give God our water and ask him to give us his wine. Let's bow our heads together. Dear Heavenly Father, we pray that this might be the experience of Preston and Sharifa. They admit that in and of themselves, they're only bringing water, but they're giving it to you. In exchange, give them wine. In Jesus' name, amen.
Preston and Sharifa, if this weren't your wedding ceremony, I would tell the musician to go to the instrument and let's open the doors of the church. As we have been ably challenged by Pastor Fordham, but specifically you, prior to our engaging in the recitation of the vows, you all have sacred, special promises that you would like to commit and share with one another. And so with that in mind, if you would come a little closer.
Praise God. Amen. My love. I prayed and I prayed, and God sent me you. Today I stand here before you because I am happier and more fulfilled. Spiritually and emotionally, now more than ever. I desire to share my love with you and my love for you. The rest for the rest of my life. Technology. Only God can teach us the meaning of true love. And where there is love, there is light. So I promise to love you unconditionally. I promise to be sensitive to your needs. I promise to be patient and let God lead. I will always hold your hand and kiss your lips. I will reflect on this day every day as a reflection of God's love for us and his understanding. See, I prayed and I prayed, and God sent me you. And there isn't anything on earth more beautiful. So with that, I would like to sing a song. Very short song, but I would do my best. You are so beautiful to me. You are so beautiful to me. Can't you see you're everything I prayed for. And God bless me with everything I need. And you are so beautiful to me. And I thank God for you.
As I stand here looking into your eyes, I want to let you know how much you mean to me and how much I love you. I promise that I will make today a promise. I'm sorry. I promise today and for this lifetime that no matter what, I will always be by your side. I promise to be your friend and your confidant, to be the person that you can rely on for support, for comfort, for laughter, and for love. I promise to always listen to you. to be open to your suggestions, and to be confident knowing that you always have my best interests at heart. I promise to be a good wife to you, to make sure that you are well fed physically, mentally, and emotionally. And I promise to make sure that our home will be a place that you can always be happy, to cherish our special moments together, like football on Sunday and the playoffs during the NBA. End of NBA, okay. I promise to be a wonderful mother to your children, to love them like our mothers loved us, and to be a blessing to them through their lives. And I promise to be your biggest cheerleader, to support you in all of your endeavors, and to be a shoulder for you to lean on. And I promise to let you be yourself and to trust your judgment. And I want you to always know that I will follow your lead. You're a strong man, and you're wise beyond your years. And God has blessed you with so many talents. So I'll trust you with all of my heart. And last, I promise to love you unconditionally, to be the wife that God wants me to be, and to keep him at the center of our marriage. I love you, sweetie. You're truly the love of my life. God made me for you, and I promise to be all that I can be for you and for him. I love you.
I must admit, Preston, when I saw you and Andre and John walking down the aisle, I was taken back 22 years ago to Cunningham Hall. And then Sharifa, when you came down the aisle, I said, look at Omari's little sister. But it's evident of your love for one another. You've professed it in the sacred promises you have just shared with one another. And now, you make a commitment not only to each other, but a commitment to the Lord. Amen. And so with that, we begin the recitation of the vows. And now, solemnly promising before God, and in the presence of these witnesses here today, will you, Preston Walker III, have this woman, Sharifa Wimbush, to be your lawfully wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the sacred estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, cherish her in sickness and in health, in prosperity or adversity, and forsaking all other, keep yourself only unto her so long as you both shall live? Do you so declare?
I do.
And will you, Sharifa Wimbush, have this man, Preston Walker III, to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the sacred estate of matrimony? Will you love, honor, and cherish him in sickness and in health, in prosperity or adversity, and forsaking all other, keep yourself only unto him so long as you both shall live? Do you so declare?
I do.
For as much as Preston Walker III and Sharifa Wimbush have consented to be joined together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and thereto have given and pledged their troth each to the other and have declared the same by the joining of hands, I, as a minister of the gospel of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, by the authority of the law of the land of the state of Alabama, do now hereby pronounce that they are husband and wife. What God hath joined together, let no man or woman put asunder. Father in heaven, this evening, Preston, Sharifa, they have come as individuals, but tonight they shall leave as one. God, I ask that you would make their house your home, a home where angels love to dwell, a home, oh God, where Jesus the Christ is a resident there. I pray for Preston that God, he would be the man, the husband that God you have called and would have him to be, and also that for Sharifa would be the wife and the woman, oh God, you've called her to be. Today they have shared their promises. Today they have recited vows. Today, they have made a commitment, Lord, to each other and a commitment to you. May Preston fully understand that his chief responsibility
is to make sure Sharifa is ready for your kingdom. May Sharifa understand that God, her chief responsibility is to prepare and help Preston make it to your kingdom. And God, when the roll is called up yonder, may their names be written there. Now we give them to you. Dedicate them as a couple, husband and wife, to your glory. God, when you are soon seen coming in the clouds of glory, I just pray that you save them. Lord, we believe that the probability pressing to make it to your kingdom is with Sharifa. And we believe the probability for Sharifa to make it to your kingdom is with Preston. So bless this union. It's in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. In many different wedding ceremonies, this time, brides, grooms choose to have different symbols to signify their love for one another and that the two have now become one. Some engage in a sand ceremony. Some engage in the tying of knots. Others engage in the uniting of candles. Whatever the method, the symbolism is the same. The two have now become one. Symbolically, Preston, Sharifa, become one.
Just before I go to sleep, I say a prayer that God will keep the two that He's joined together. Find shelter in each other's arms, where love's a fire that keeps us warm. And when we're laid down with care, we're gonna take just the right words to say, words that will help us find our way. And when we are blinded by pride and greed, open our eyes. Teach us to laugh and to cry, to kiss away the tears from each other's eyes. We'll be patient. Just the way that you divine hearts made help us to laugh and to cry, to kiss away tears from each other's eyes. Yes, we'll be patient and we'll be kind and love each other just the way that you design.
Preston, now you may kiss your bride.
I'd like to introduce to you the newest couple, Huntsville, Alabama, Mr. and Mrs. Preston and Sharifa Walker III.